warm welcome to the SPMS Europe 2018. On my side is Chris. Chris, please introduce yourself and what is your profession?
Yeah, my name is Chris Gilbert. I work for Evonik Oil Additives. We're a business line within Evonik that produces an additive to increase efficiency in lubricating fluids. My function is I'm in charge of operations for our business line.
Okay, do you have tomorrow the keynote? The last presentation, what is the topic and what will you tell the audience?
So one of the things I want to talk about tomorrow is what's actually going to be happening in the future. I have some really interesting statistics that most people I don't think understand or maybe even know about in terms of demographics. And it's really going to force us, I believe, to automate even faster. And we're going to be have to doing some other things with people. And so what I want to talk about is what specifically can we do with people who may be displaced from their jobs? And how do we turn this into a competitive advantage?
Do we have some ideas about to prevent the future to not have homeless people all around and normal working people?
I think it's a great challenge for the industry. I actually have five strategies that I'll quickly introduce about what you can do with people who may be losing their jobs and how to actually help them add more value to the company.
What is your first impression about the SPMS Europe?
Oh, I think it's a very nice collection of a variety of companies with some interesting ideas. And so I think it's nice to come here to have a good overview of what's going on and what could possibly happen in the future.
On which current project you're working for? It's the topic of a presentation, or do you have other projects you're working on?
Well, I would say actually certainly people development is a crucial aspect for myself. I'm in charge of operations and we have a lot of people that we have to take care of within our business line. And so my presentation just kind of grew out of a kernel of an idea about what happens 10 and 20 years from now.
And do you feel the process already starting or it's in the middle or what do you think?
I think the recognition is slowly starting to come. I don't think we've really necessarily started. And I think even within our industry, specifically the plants that I deal with, the automation is challenging right now as we're a batch chemical plant. However, some creative ideas will come.
What kind of people you need for a factory in the future in 20 years?
I think one of the things that we would really want to move towards is actually hiring engineers to actually do what we would consider an operator's role today. We've had great success with this in other plants where we've taken people, hired them as engineers, and developed them into plant managers. And I think having a higher level of education is one way you're going to be able to differentiate yourself from competitors.
Evonik have some future plans already in mind, or it's only a project to think about what can be happened in the future?
So, of course, our company is huge, and I can't really speak for the entire company at all. Certainly, we have digitalization efforts that are ongoing, and we definitely have a lot of people development activities as well.
Okay, so not concrete.
Correct.
What will change in the next 3-5 years in the manufacturing side?
Certainly, we'll see some more automation. That'll definitely be changing. And I think we'll be starting to grab some of the things, for instance, that IBM from Watson was showing about how are we taking this existing data collection that we have, all of these sensors, the temperatures, the pressures, the flows, and actually doing something with it. Because he's exactly right. I'm a process engineer, and a lot of times when you design things, you're like, oh, a temperature gauge would be wonderful here, or pressure. And we're not really using this. And so you either should use it or you should just get rid of it. And I think it's better to actually use the things that you already have. And that'll be an exciting development.
Thank you for your time and for short insight. I wish you a great presentation tomorrow.
Thank you very much.